Hello, Zero K fans! This is Shadow Fury 33 bringing you another exhibition match stream of Zero K. Tonight we're going to start out with a replay between Ivan D and Kaen, both fairly up and coming players, although neither of which I don't recall being in any tournaments, but I have seen them play a lot recently and they seem to be doing fairly well, seem to be just rising up the yellow ladder. So I figure I should cast them since they're probably going to be in the next tournament. Although, admittedly, the next one's a 2v2 tournament, but hey, they might decide to team up in that one too. So, let us begin. There we go. Well, okay, once the game says yes. There we go. So Kaen going for a shield buff after we're on Desert Cliffs, by the way. Rather smallish map, if you haven't seen this before. It's fairly basic, kind of small. One player starts at the top, one at the bottom. You can actually start along the entire bottom or top, but basically, one at the bottom, one at the top, and then you have about a dozen metal spots, each of which is 2.5 metal each, rather than the standard 2. So it's a little bit more per spot, which is probably going to be meaningful, but there aren't so many spots overall. There's also one rock in the main base for reclaim, and a geothermal geyser in the back. Anyway, like I said, Kaen going for shield bots, while Ivan D also going for shield bots, which have been somewhat buffed recently, although not too especially buffed. I think it's more of a metagame shift of late. Anyway, Bandit coming in, getting rid of Ivan D's radar, but no mech destruction. Ivan D is relying on reclaim from the very start, while Kaen, on the other hand, relying more heavily on getting a static economy going, which is actually giving them a bit of a disadvantage. Though Ivan D does manage to get rid of one of the metal extractors, loses the Bandit in the process, but that was still a very valuable raid. Getting rid of a metal extractor, a couple wind generators on top of the metal extractor, and the radar tower. So Ivan D, kind of behind, economically about even, but is kind of behind, is actually floating a bit too, hasn't been producing recently. While Kaen on the other end has been producing a bit, they do have a couple extra bandits, but at this point, they don't seem to be moving forward with it, and I just realized that the core selector on. I do want to have that as part of the whole stats display, but at present, not available. That is something I want to do eventually, though. And yeah, Ketabor pointing out that there were Bandit and Outlaw buffs. They were minor, but they helped. They were just big thing was the Outlaw speed, and I believe, I don't think Outlaw damage is buffed recently, but Bandits, I think, were given a slight damage buff. I'm not sure offhand. If someone knows in the chat, please correct me. I can't really check the changelog at the moment. Anyhow, Ivan D decided to go along the northwest, expanding up the hills, trying to take a bit more of a defensible position, while Kaen, on the other hand, going towards the southeast, essentially the symmetric position, but Ivan D is also running their bandits through, which does mean that they are kind of hinting at their setup there. Kaen, on the other hand, is trying to attack from essentially the weakest position, although admittedly there is a late, well actually Lotus is all around this base, so attacking is going to be fairly tricky. While Kaen does go in for more slow cutters in the main base, they have more metal extractors along the entire south side. They are building metal faster. In fact, overall resource production is faster than Ivan D. Ivan D focusing much more on defense. Okay, well you can see in the chat what Ketabor's, what the buffs are. Yeah, you can see that cost reduction and range and AI buff for the bandits. The outlaw speed buff is actually a bit of an older one, but yes, that is still very important. And we have been seeing the effects of that for a little while now. Actually, looks like Kaen going for Felon Outlaw. Actually, okay, Felon Thug Law. That makes a bit more sense. While Ivan D, on the other hand, is going much more pure Thug Law. Thug Law into Bandit. Well, Bandit support, but primarily Thug Law. Which will be interesting. The Felon is going to be a little bit hard to support without the Thug. So it kind of depends on Ivan D attacks. But Kaen is going for a small assault. Not that much, though. Pulling back, losing a couple bandits in the process. Unfortunately for Kaen, no real result from there. Going to kill one of Ivan D's bandits, but ultimately going to lose their entire force. One other bandit goes down. They have to retreat. I mean, really, Kaen has no easy way in. Ivan D, however, has kind of turtled themselves into a corner. There are a lot of Lotuses here, but Kaen has far more of the map, far more economy overall, a far stronger economy overall. Ivan D's a bit more energy, though. But Kaen is a far stronger economy, could easily build more energy than we needed to, and they will actually not need to. But should point out that Felons and Thugs, like, see, the energy per second cost is zero. Everything other than Aspis and Aegis, which are the same unit basically, have a zero energy cost on shield production. Their shields are free. Just worth pointing that out. So right now Kaen is not actually having any problems due to a lack of energy. The radar, however, is causing a small issue, but overall not that problematic. And Ivan D is running too close to that felon. Gotta be careful about that, because that felon will get rid of the bandits, no problem. The thug law is gonna be where the felon's gonna have issues. Fighting Ivan D's thug law with felon is not gonna work out too well for the felon, but it may work out with the right support units. That's the one thing. It really will come down to the support units that Kaen throws in there, but that felon will only be useful for getting rid of the raiding forces that come around. Any bandits that come into support, that sort of thing. Which does mean that Ivan D could theoretically have more room to move their own bandits around, but even then, this outlaw is going to be basically putting a stop to that. Largely going to come down to positioning, but I think Kaen really should just focus on more production, getting more energy, getting more metal overall. Like, just push as much as you can, because Kaen has the economic advantage very heavily. Ivan D is trying to raid this out, does manage to get rid of one of the metal extractors, but can't really move too far forward beyond that. So Kaen does have the economic advantage, has had the economic lead the entire game, has a military lead as well, and has a production lead on top of that. No caretakers or builders of any sort in Ivan D's factories. Kaen, on the other hand, is actually pushing 30 metal per second into their shieldbot factory. No sign of a factory switch, which makes sense at this point. They probably just want to go for pretty solid thug. Mostly thug, actually. Not much outlaw, just thug felon. And with enough thugs, this thug ball won't even matter, actually. Just basically how it's going to work is for every thug in Kane's force here, that's going to reduce the shields out of a thug in Ivan D's force, but then, of course, there's also the health that needs to be reduced. But yeah, from the felon alone, because the shield charge to the felon, I think, okay, that's not entirely true, because that assumes a one-to-one ratio on damage for shield energy, but I'm not sure what the ratio is in damage for shield energy, to be perfectly honest. That I should probably look up. It's not particularly clear. Yeah, it doesn't actually say. Damage per second is 723, so I'm guessing that it's greater than one. I'm guessing that you get more than one damage per point of shield. So actually, given the sheer amount of effort put into defenses here, I think Kaen's going to be able to steamroll this. Ivan D is focused way too much on defenses. Kaen has managed to just outproduce Ivan D by nearly a factor of two. If you discount the commanders, which are each worth about 1,200, it pretty much becomes a factor of two difference. Well, the felon doesn't even matter how much the felon deals damage, because there's all these support units here. All the thugs, the outlaws, the bandits. Everything else just comes in as support. And a roach, however, very nicely placed roach by Ivan D. That completely turns this around, forcing Kaen out of there and giving Ivan D a lot of breathing room, which they desperately needed. But that was exactly perfect. Exactly the right thing to do. Very well done, Ivan D. Perfect defense there, and there are no other roaches on the field right now, though, but that was exactly what needed to be done. Well done, Ivan D. That was good. Now, just need to put more production in, because Ivan D is floating quite a lot. Has actually gotten an economic advantage next to the... No, actually, not even reclaim. Looks like it's pure overdrive on metal extractors. And the center metal extractor, Ivan D is basically caught up. Just needs to produce more. That's the big thing. Ivan D needs to push metal into this factory. If that's done, Ivan D could turn this around. But at the moment, Kaen is the only one pushing that in, so that roach is basically moot. Or has been rendered moot as a result of Ivan D not taking advantage of the sheer damage that they dealt to Kane's forces with that one roach. Which unfortunately looks like it will cost them the game. I mean, it's going to take a little while though. Kaen has to push through a lot of defenses. Ivan D has bought themselves a lot of time as a result. Like, the three lotuses here are going to be problematic. They're going to be a pain. It's going to force Kaen to probably switch to racketeers, actually. Which surprisingly they haven't. I don't think they're aware of that. Let's just double check. They must be aware of this. Yeah, they're fully aware of this. This is from Kane's point of view. They do have some knowledge that there were lotuses there. Kaen is fully aware of those lotuses, and now also aware of these lotuses in Faraday over in the northwest side of the map. Losing a few bandits in the process, not a big loss at this stage in the game. But also should point out that really, there is another roach, but that's the only big threat. That's the thing that Kaen has to be really mindful of, and actually Kaen will not be mindful of it because, I should have pointed this out far sooner. Eraser roach? Theorized to be broken some time ago, and well, I'm not sure if it's broken, it's definitely very powerful because the roach is cloaked while stationary, but not while moving. With the eraser, it's cloaked while moving. And Ivan D is taking advantage of that, pushing the eraser gradually forward. Very nice slow push here. And this eraser just moving forward. And the roaches, they are taking full advantage of this, getting rid of Kane's forces. And Ivan D, despite the production disadvantage, is basically able to avoid any real problems. It just got rid of Green. There's Kane's forces gone. I'm rendered speechless as a result of that, or at least incapable of coherent speech briefly, because two roaches like that tear apart Kane's forces, and Ivan D now in the lead. Massively in the lead. But like I said, the downside is Ivan D is... Okay, there we go. I was about to say, not producing enough, but now they are. They have realized the float and are pushing heavily, getting the production advantage. Kaen, on the other hand, is starting to float, has switched over to gunships, trying to go for brawlers instead, which makes sense given the switch for Roach, but down goes Kane's commander, which from there you can see how... just how big of an effect Ivan D's Roach has had. Kaen losing basically everything, and yeah, that's it. That was a comeback. Ivan D's actually managed to push back from this, and we finally see on a casted game the power of Eraser and Roach together. I've been rather curious about that. It's been talked about for months, but I've never actually seen it happen in one of the casted games. I've actually seen it happen in any of the games I've played either. Though, granted, I normally play Cloakybot, but still. You could still do the same thing with Ticks. It's less powerful, but it could be done. It's just Eraser's not a unit people build much. I mean, it's 600 metal for cloaking effect, which is actually really powerful, but it's 600 metal, and you think, well, I could get 10 glaives for that cost. And yeah, you could get 10 glaives for that cost. It's rather important to point that out, but you could also be able to simply have 20 glaives worth of effectiveness if you use a Tick with that, or a Roach with that, and it's just, you're done. You just go. So yeah, the Brawler is coming in, trying to do what it can, and Racketeer's coming in to stomp it, not even going for the Vandal, just going straight for the Racketeer, just to stun it out, well, disarm it out, and then continue the push. There isn't really much that Ivan D has on the ground right now to actually stop the Brawler outright, but stopping it from attacking would be a good first step. Now, I should point out that Kaen still does have quite a lot of map presence, but overall, it's fairly equal. Neither player has a distinct advantage in terms of map control, but Ivan D does have a military advantage, so even if they're even on production and even on economy, Ivan D is just well ahead in terms of units. It's just a matter of having the right units to actually deal with all this. And apparently, shielded units don't cloak. Or if they do, it's not clear. And unfortunately, Racketeer being a bit wasted on a geothermal plant nanoframe. While the Brawlers are tearing apart Ivan D's economy, actually Kaen doing far more damage than really is justified. Honestly, there are Vandals being built up now, but that Racketeer could have been best used to deal with these Brawlers, which ultimately the Vandals will deal with, or no, never mind, would have dealt with, but for the geothermal plant going off, still enough Vandals coming in on top of this to get rid of the Brawlers. Losing that geothermal plant is not a small thing, nor is losing those metal extractors. That's about 7.5 metal gone right there. Or 7.5 metal per second gone right there. And Ivan D's commander is also going to go down thanks to those Brawlers. It, well, would have gone down. In fact, is he going to go down? Yes, Ivan D's commander does go down. So both commanders have gone down. And with that, Ivan D losing the economic advantage, losing the caretakers. Factory production advantage is gone. But Ivan D goes for the counterattack and probably will win as a result of this. Factory is going to go down very shortly. The gunship factory is about to go down. I have a really bad habit of doing that. Whatever unit is basically the meta for one factory, because gunships are primarily used for brawlers nowadays. And yeah, that's it. Kaen still goes down. Ivan D does solidify that comeback. And that game is solidly Ivan D's. Kaen has thrown the towel, and that was it. Well done, both players. That was very entertaining to watch. So hope you enjoyed that, and I'll have another game for you guys in just a moment. Taking a while to alt tab today. Don't know why. Anyhow, I'll be back with that in just a moment. It will be a game between Ivan D once again versus Orphelius on Titan Duel. Stay tuned for that. It'll be up in just a moment.